back to receive it. Nick Dougal. And this will be Stuckey from inside the 5-yard line. Right up the middle, breaks to the outside. He's got some running room. Over midfield, still on his feet, and finally knocked out of bounds inside the 35-yard line. They'll mark it at the 33. We have a penalty on the play. Well, Bill Snyder telling us yesterday, Kelly, special teams will be important. I think we thought that he meant his team.
Yeah, exactly.
On offense.
That's really one of his trademarks. Bill Snyder wants special teams to figure prominently into the outcome of a game, but he won that third phase.
67 yards on the kickoff return. Jake Sharp, who's battled injuries this year after a couple of 100-yard rushing games early on, in the backfield with Reesing. They fake to Sharp, the quick out, just what we thought. Well, one thing that Mark Mangino told us about as we take a look at our free creditreport.com starting lineups, there's been a shakeup on the offensive line. Thorson to right tackle. Marangelli starts at right guard. Capra to left guard. We expected that after last week's performance.
Well, the playmakers have to make plays. Briscoe, we've already seen. Meyer, they simply have to hold on to the football.
Sharp on second and short. Nice job by the middle of that Kansas State defense. Let's take a look at that Kansas State defense. They have shown a lot of improvement. Jeffy Fitzgerald, the defensive end, has been the leader of this team and leads in sacks and a linebacker, Kelly.
That second level, Ron, is going to have to be out in pass coverage a lot, but they also have to defend the run when the opportunity presents itself.
9 interceptions by the secondary. Tyson Hartman has 4 of those. Third down, we'll call it 5.
You can see, Ron, a lot of press coverage. Kansas State likes their matchup out wide.
They bring 5. Reesing over the middle to carry Meyer. He's got the first down inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. Pickup of 18 on the play.
And, Ron, we've seen Kansas already coming out in multiple wide receivers. Meyer's just going to go inside, essentially a rub route, offensive receivers going downfield, taking the coverage with them, and Meyer comes underneath of that.
In Big 12 play, only 10 first-quarter points for Kansas. Tobin Oprim now behind Reesing. He looks over to the sideline. Reesing has never lost at Kansas State. Oprim down to the 5-yard line. Homeli on the tackle, the middle linebacker out of Santa Rosa, California. Is this the kind of start that we expected? Because those passes weren't exactly difficult ones to start the game for Reesing.
Yeah, I think in the approach, absolutely, Ron. I think the result is certainly what Kansas wants, but Ed Warner wants Reesing to get that good feel, that good taste in his mouth early. He hasn't had it recently. That's why those short passes, a quarterback needs to feel that rhythm.
Catches than he did through 3 quarters versus Texas Tech. Only had 3 total in that ball game. Here's Reesing. Oprim goes to the left. Reesing is going to be sacked. Texas Tech sacked him 6 times last week. He's been dropped 9 times in the last 2 games. That's Daniel Calvin wrapping him up.
And Calvin's going to be coming from inside, and he actually makes a swim move right there over the top of number 69, Trevor Marangelli, right there. A quick move inside by a big body tackle, Ron. That's a pretty good football move right there.
Third down and goal to go from the 17-yard line. It is loud at Bill Snyder Family Stadium. Looks at Oprim coming across the middle. Pass is complete. McDougal, he is going to be well short of the end zone. Be knocked down at about the 12-yard line. If you're Mark Mangino right now, Kelly, how disappointed are you?
I think you're disappointed at that sack in a critical spot on the field in red zone. You don't want to take a sack. Reesing is that veteran quarterback, Ron. Even though the pressure was quick, you got to get that ball out of there.
Well, this is going to be about a 30-yarder. He's Jacob Brandstetter, 3 of 5 this year from the distance. Barry Meyer, the holder. High snap. Meyer brings it down. Kick is on the way, and it is no good. A looking at it again.
Brandstetter just looks like he pushes it right from the beginning. There isn't really any hook to it. It's just pushed out right from the beginning. But if you're Kansas, you want to get points. You don't like taking the sack. Reising probably needs to throw that ball away quicker. But if you're Kansas State, Ron, that's their defensive MO. They want to come up with one drive-killing play in the course of a series to try to get off the field and keep the opposition out of the end zone. That's a great look at it on that drive.
And Kansas State will take over. First and 10 from their own 20-yard line. What a defensive stop by Kansas State after the big kickoff return by the Jayhawks. Brent Gregory is the quarterback, the sixth-year senior out of Athens, Ohio. Looking left, throwing left. Ball is on the ground. They'll call it incomplete. Snipes could not get his hands on it. Well, this offense leads the Big 12 in time of possession. Grant Gregory granted a sixth year of eligibility. Kelly, he's taken advantage of that. Nothing glitzy, but talking to him yesterday and watching him, he's passionate.
Yeah, he's passionate about the game, and he's solid in executing the game plan. I think that's why he's in there, coupled with the fact that he brings a little better element to the run game. Bill Snyder wants his quarterback to be a viable runner in this offense.
Daniel Thomas behind Gregory in the backfield. And he'll have his first carry. He is a big back. Breaks over the right side. Still on his feet to the 40-yard line. Pick up a 20 on the play before Stuckey brought him down.
Just keep an eye on the back door right here. Everything starts to the left. It's the good vision. The cut right there. No contain on the back side by number 90, Andre Boulay. He needs to do a better job of squeezing down, shutting that back door. Thomas took full advantage of it on that play.
Thomas is a big guy, 6'2", 227 pounds. He carries the ball and catches about 35% of his offense. This time he's tripped up. Let's take a look at Kansas State's offensive line. Nick Stringer at left tackle. He is the only senior that is anchoring that line, and the skill position players, Kelly.
Well, just keep an eye, as we talked about, on Banks and Thomas. They're the guys that are going to be the workhorses. Banks in the big chunks, Thomas on the ground, as we've already seen on this drive.
And here is Thomas from the Wildcat formation. He breaks open into the secondary. Penalty flag goes down as he gets inside the 40 down to the 38-yard line. When you look at Kansas State run what everybody calls the Wildcat, and when Thomas is back there, they still do everything pretty normal.
And what it forces is the defense to have to bring another run defender from the secondary down to get a run fit.
Personal foul. Flipping on the offense. Number 81. 15-yard penalty. Second down.
That's on Snipes. Snipes got no back is our referee today. Let's take a look at the Wildcat.
Well, it's a direct snap to the ball carrier, and it forces the defense. You can see the lead blocker right there in 37, Wilson. But what it does, Ron, it forces the defense to bring another guy out of the secondary into the box to become a run defender because the quarterback no longer is doing the ball exchange. It's a direct snap to the primary ball carrier. That's why it pressures the defense.
Gregory goes back in at quarterback. Sometimes during the Wildcat, he will be split out to the right. Wilson comes out the fullback. And now Thomas behind Gregory with six to snap. Here's Thomas. Stood up as he crosses the 40 to the 42-yard line. John Williams lowers the boom. Let's take a look at the Kansas defense. The best player on that defensive line, no question, Jake Lapted. He's going to be playing both inside and outside today.
Well, level number two, the linebackers are going to have to get good run fits because we've already seen a very physical run game by Kansas State.
And in the secondary for Kansas State, DJ Bashir is a quarterback, only his third start. He's a true freshman. Third down and eight from the 42-yard line for Kansas State. Gregory rolling, looks to throw back to Mastrud, his tight end. And he is surrounded by white jerseys, and he's going to lose about 2 yards. Chris Harris, the junior out of Bixby, Oklahoma, led the charge.
Kansas State went three wide to one side, Ron, and kind of overloading the wide side of the field, and then the tight end screen back to the left side. But Mastrud is nursing a foot injury coming into this game. I don't know that that's the guy to throw a screen to on third and eight.
Well, they ran it successfully against Oklahoma last week, and I think Kansas obviously saw the same tape that we did. Kansas puts a little rush on. This is not going to be a good kick, but it gets a Kansas State roll. Bradley McDougal will let it go. And it'll be down inside the 15-yard line, 47 yards on the kick. Curtis begins their second drive with four field position.
And remember that Kansas's offense is orchestrated all from the sideline. Reesing does very little of it at the line of scrimmage.
Here's Jake Sharp, who had an outstanding game last year versus Kansas State. Had 181 yards rushing and four touchdowns. Started the year with a couple of 100-yard games. Then that lower left leg seemed to bother him during the Duke game that you and I saw.
Yeah, and I think he's the key, don't you, Ron?
Oh, absolutely.
You talked about him getting healthy, probably healthier this week than he has been since that injury, and that's vital for this offense.
That was a quiet 7 yards he picked up on that carry. Ball on the 20, second down and three, and again, Reesing looks over to the sideline. They use a lot of hand signals in this offense. Reesing looks. Down over the 30 to the 32-yard line. Desmond Briscoe, the junior out of Dallas, Texas, his 190th catch in his career. He's tied with Kerry Meyer for number one in Kansas history.
And one of the foundational principles of Kansas's offense is they put Briscoe over here by himself, and they just want to see how the defense reacts to it. If they have a favorable matchup, they go to that side. If not, they just flip it and go to Meyer and company on the other side of the field.
It's early, but Reesing seems to be throwing the ball better than he did the last 2 weeks we've seen. Here's Sharp. Nothing doing. He'll be stopped right at the line of scrimmage and may even lose a foot. Darius Thomas, the true freshman out of Cedar Hill High School in Dallas, Texas, coming up to make the stop.
Ron, I think the true test is if Reesing can escape the pocket, his improvisational type skill where he keeps the play alive, wants to throw the ball downfield even though he gets out of the pocket. I want to see him escape before I say he's his old self once again.
A second down and 11. Last week they wanted to distribute the ball more evenly around the wide receivers and running backs. Little play action. Reesing sees some pressure. Hit as he throws. It's a wobbly pass and a penalty flag will be thrown. Two of them. Reesing, though, again, Kelly, the pocket collapsing on him.
Yeah, and I quite frankly, he's still not moving around in the pocket very well. The pressure that Kansas State has gotten on him, he just hasn't been able to get away. But once again, they're going to the one-on-one matchup off the play-action pass to that man right there, Briscoe. Underthrown, poor pass. Kansas State had pressure, but Lemoore didn't do a very good job of defending that ball down the field.
Well, Felder, Antonio Felder, coming up from that defensive end spot, really started to put the pressure on Reesing, and I think he may have gotten a piece of the arm.
Yeah, I think you're right.
As that ball was wobbling like a duck out there. That's first and 10 now from the 46 for the Jayhawks. They had the ball first, had a 67-yard kickoff return, and missed a field goal after that. Reesing on the roll again. This one is wobbly. And Reesing kind of throws the right arm like, where'd that come from?
We can take another look at Reesing getting out of the pocket. Very measured on his movement. I'm telling you right now, something is not right. Take a look at him getting out. There's a little gimp in his step right there. And then that's the torque that causes problems with the groin. When you have to try to get square to the line of scrimmage and throw in an awkward position, it's a problem. Reesing is not right physically.
4 of 5 for 40 yards. He's got 5 to snap it. He's got 2 to snap it. 1 to snap it. They barely get it off. He pitches it to Sharp. No, we do have a penalty flag. He didn't get it off.
Delay a game. On the offense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
He thought he got it off.
I think he did too. He looked up and saw 1 and he tried to get it snapped.
But, Ron, what's interesting is when a quarterback, I don't want to beat this thing to death, but when a quarterback doesn't have his best asset, sometimes you also start to kind of lose control of the other aspects of your game. You don't throw it away down in the red zone when a veteran quarterback knows better. And on that play, mismanagement of the play clock, you lose your focus when you're not feeling right physically.
After the penalty, moves back to second and 15 from the 40. passing. This time has time. Pass is complete to Briscoe, and he's got a first down. Lemure on the coverage, taking a look at that again from the field level.
Well, Briscoe's part of a two-man rat out wide. You can see Reesing looks to the left, or to his right, comes back to the left. It's a two-man route, the traditional curl with someone going to the flat, and Briscoe is that guy that finds that void.
Inside of 5:45 left in quarter number one. The Sunflower Showdown. Here comes Reesing. This had a little better spiral on it. Pass is complete. Jonathan Wilson over the 40 down to the 38-yard line. Stephen Harrison on the coverage. That is Wilson's 28th catch of the year.
You can see on that play that Reesing, when he boots, typically he has some type of an escort. In that case, it was number 69, the right guard, and Marangelli. They typically don't leave him naked outside. They pull the lineman and escort him around the corner.
Kansas.
This is the matchup that K-State has to prove that they can defend.
And Reesing's looking at Briscoe right as you circle. Pass almost intercepted. Emmanuel Lemure, the sophomore out of West Palm Beach, Florida, almost had his third interception of the season.
And Briscoe is out there waiting, but what happened is they got a defender underneath, out wide under Briscoe, and Reesing tried to come back into the tight end, and it just wasn't there. Another forced attempt by Reesing.
And another third down and long. It is six. Kansas State getting a player off the field. They had too many on it. Six to snap it as Meyer goes in motion. Looking, throwing to Meyer. Caught. And it's going to be close to the first down as he gets down to the 33-yard line. Troy Butler on the coverage.
Meyer is going to go in motion and run what they call an angle route. Act like he's going to the flat. He's going to come back in the screen right there. Third, you know, first down depth. He's a very heady former quarterback. He knows the distance that he needs to get.
Now they're going to go for it on fourth and one. O'Perham, he's got the first down to the 29-yard line. I like the quick snap Mark Mangino called. He calls the plays from the sideline. You can hear him, you can read his lips saying, good job. Yeah, he was very upset when we talked to him Wednesday about his offensive line.
Yeah,
and that's putting it very mild.
Yeah, the offensive line sets the attitude on the offensive side of the ball, and he doesn't think his guys are physical enough, consistently enough on the offensive side. He's challenged them this year continuously.
We hit the 4-minute mark with quarter number one. Snap. The fake to Sharp. Reesing has some time. Plenty of time. Looking deep, and it's going to be picked off. Nobody was there. Lemure with the interception. And Reesing misses the tackle, and then he's finally knocked out of back down at the 45-yard line. A penalty fly because it was a shot to the head. It looked like Trevor Marangelli is the one only flag.
Reesing is going to throw late across the middle, and the safety from the opposite side, and Lemure is the guy who is just reading the eyes. Reesing starts to the right side and comes off late. Throwing late across the middle is never a good idea, and a veteran quarterback knows better than that.
And he was shook up on the play after the shot to the head. Anything
was
above the shoulder pads, you're going to get flagged.
It was the old-time elbow, it looked like to me, that just caught him flat.
Well, Reesing, I'm surprised. Watch Reesing, too, because he kind of just dove at his feet.
And actually, it looked like Emmanuel Lemure was out of bounds right there with his left foot.
Yeah, he's out of bounds there.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness.
Oh, my.
That
was the helmet.
First down, Kansas State. Timeout on the field.
That's to be determined. College football, of course, is on Versus. So Kansas State with great field position at the 48-yard line now of Kansas. Kansas showing blitz, and here they come. Gregory, quick pass in the flat, incomplete. Let's go back to that interception once again and take a look exactly and see what Emmanuel Lemure did.
Well, Briscoe is going to run to the post. It's late. Freeze it right there. Watch this safety as Briscoe works up the field. This safety has nothing to do but read the quarterback. That's who ends up picking up picking off this pass. Reesing has to keep track of that safety. Did a poor job through late interception. The veteran quarterback, Ron, should know better than that.
And, of course, Emmanuel with the interception trying to get the cobwebs out of his head. We've got who I'm sure is on the sideline. Does he have his bucket hat on today, though?
I'm sure he does because the sun is beating down.
Had to go to the bucket. Here is Banks. The little guy gets to the outside and got a first down. All 5'7", 150 pounds of him.
We talked about Banks at the top. This is the big play guy for this offense. They want to grind it out, and then they give it to this speed buggy right here at 5'7", 150. The change of direction, that little extra gear that he has to kick it into a gear that most people walking around on the planet simply don't have.
Bill Snyder calls him the smallest young guy he has ever seen in his career. They list him 5'7", 150. We need a tape measure and a scale because we don't believe it. A little bit smaller than that. Thomas is upended as he gets inside the 35 down to the 33-yard line. But what we've already seen in this game, Kelly, is a Bill Snyder trademark. He attacks the whole field with his offense.
He really does, and he does a nice job offensively of kind of highlighting your strengths. And right now it's the running back Thomas and it's Brandon Banks on the plays that we saw, like on the reverse. They want to pound you down the middle, and then they want to get big chunks once in a while to the edges with guys like Banks.
Lamarck Brown goes wide to the right. Three wide receiver set on second down and eight. Here's Thomas. Squares his shoulders again, breaks into the secondary. He'll be about a yard short of the first down. Here's more on Brandon Banks from Lewis.
Ron, guys, before the game, I mean,
both of those things make him maybe 5'7", but he is quick.
Well, they're about a yard and a half short. They're calling it two, so Wilson will be the fullback. Thomas behind him. Here's Thomas dancing around. Kansas is going to stack him up, and he's actually going to lose about a half a yard. DJ Bashir's coming in along with Caleb Blakeslee. Oh, sorry, DJ, got to bring the ball back. They need that to play.
I think Kansas State's in that kind of tweener area. They would probably go for it right here. Doesn't really do you much good to punt it, and it would be a pretty long field goal attempt right here.
Yeah, and they're not real sure about Josh Cherry. He had a couple of PATs blocked last week, so they're going to go for it on fourth down. 10 of 17 this year, 59%. I'm surprised they didn't use the Wildcat formation for this. Gregory looks over to the side with three to snap it. Looking right, holding on to the football, has a man down the sideline, overthrown, incomplete, intended for Brown.
Gregory was trying to get the ball to the flat to Mastrud underneath, and then Brown is going down the sideline right there. Nothing is underneath. Throw the ball to him right here. He actually had him, just airmailed it. You know, that quick decision right at the end to go to a receiver you didn't expect to throw the football to. The ball got away from him just a little bit.
And Bill Snyder's team comes up empty after putting up some yardage. And we are still scoreless. Final 51 seconds here in the first. Todd Reesing and company take over. Only 66 yards so far in the ballgame for a very high potent offense. To the 23-yard line. Now, Wednesday, December 2nd on Versus, you'll find out what it takes to tackle the world's toughest sports jobs. Join NFL All-Pro linebacker Junior Seau as he does the jobs that make sports really work. Sports Jobs with Junior Seau. The series kicks off Wednesday, December 2nd, 10 Eastern, with two all-new episodes only on Versus. And now, Kale Pick is in at quarterback. Kale Pick, I should say, is joining Todd Reesing in the backfield. Here's Reesing. Pass is tipped.
I'm not exactly sure what Kansas is trying to do in the game right now. They're coming back with that two running back set, but one of them is Kale Pick. Right there taking the fake, and then Ahuram is going to the flat underneath. Fitzgerald gets a mid on it, but if you're going to go two back, put Jake Sharp back there with a big body to burn.
Third down and 15 for Reesing.
you're setting something up down the road. We'll see if Pick maybe throws out of that formation.
Reesing, a little shuttle pass, and that's going to be an incomplete pass. Oh, Purim, it looked like it may have hit him in the face. That was
quarterback going down. That may prove to be the thing that we've expected to see for the last few weeks.
Well, let's see if Kansas State can do anything offensively. They only have 55 total yards on 12 plays. Gregory's going upstairs, has a man, Banks down the middle, reaches up, doesn't bring it in. The ball seemed to be floating on him. He made that almost same reception last week versus Oklahoma. Couldn't get it this time. Justin Thornton coming up from that defensive back position.
I think you're right. It's play action pass, and the ball floated just a little bit right there at the end. Not that tight spiral. It ends up behind Banks at 5'7". He tries to go up and get it, and Thornton is there to break up the pass. But they had exactly what they wanted, yeah. Ron. Actually, I think the ball, Gregory could have put that ball a little bit more across the field, and it would have been better for Banks.
Gregory keeps it. He adds this dimension. You know, when Carson Kaufman started the season, Carson is an outstanding student, a great individual, but he was more of a pocket passer. When they went to Gregory, they thought that just maybe this would fit Bill Snyder's offense,
yeah,
more, which is usually featured a quarterback who can run the football.
Yeah, I think you have it exactly right. They wanted that element that the quarterback is a viable option in the run game, and Kaufman really isn't that at this point in time.
Now third down and 7, Kansas State this afternoon on 3rd and 7, 0 for 2. Banks dancing around. Here comes the blitz. He reads it. That should be pass interference, and here come the flags. Justin Thornton wrapped up Banks before the ball got to him.
Pass interference on a defense number 46. Ball be placed, spot of the foul. Automatic. First down.
Ron, what Kansas State wants to do, the reason that Banks is in motion at 5'7", 150, you don't want him to get pressed in a stationary position on the line of scrimmage. So you put him in motion, he can get a free release and utilize his quickness, and Thornton couldn't keep up with him on that play.
Well, that's the third penalty against Kansas this afternoon. Puts the ball on the 41-yard line. Now Gregory looks over to the side. Dana Dimmel, co-offensive coordinator, along with Del Miller. Gregory looks left, throws right, passes incomplete, just out of the outstretched arms of his intended receiver, Atrell Snipes, the senior out of Seattle, Washington. Snipes limped off the game versus OU last week, but he looks fine today.
And Ron, and I think Kansas State is pretty ordinary outside except for Banks' skill set. I think the rest of the guys really just bring kind of that ordinary element, and Snipes is one of them. You have to catch the football well, and he didn't do it on that play.
And that brings up 2nd down and 10. And they'll go from the shotgun again, and Gregory will put it up again. This time the pass is complete over the 45-yard line to Brandon Banks out of Garner, North Carolina.
Once again, just another way for Banks to get loose. Soft coverage, just use your speed and quickness of getting out of the break. And I like Grant Gregory throwing the football when he sets his feet and gets it out on time. Sometimes he's not good down below with his feet, and the ball doesn't come out right. It comes out late. That was a good throw on that play.
Back up to Matt Grody for 3 years at South Florida, where he got his degree from. Getting his master's now, and Gregory up top again, wide open, Mistrew. The tight end, and he's inside the 35, down to the 34-yard line. Lubbock Smith on the stop.
The big tight end, Mistrew, comes underneath. Brown basically almost forms a pick for him outside. Quarterback doing a nice job of holding the safety over the middle until the big tight end shows up in your line of vision. Ron, when you're throwing the football, you keep your head downfield. You know where your guys are going to show up, and that's a good example of it by Gregory on that play.
One reception. We had motion in the backfield, Wilson. But that's one reception in each of the last 26 games for Mistrud, and looked like Wilson
ball
just
start.
Leaned forward.
On the offense, number 37, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Now let's take neither team over 100 yards offense yet in this ball game. Here's Thomas. Dances around, breaks into the secondary. He is so difficult to bring down. He's slow getting up. He's been bothered by a shoulder injury. But he is 35% of their offense, Kelly. He takes a lot of hits.
He's quick-footed for 6'2", almost 230 pounds. Watch how he makes the safety miss right there. That's a safety coming up in run support in Lubbock. Smith, number 13. A little quick move outside, jumps back up inside. That's a big-bodied back making that move.
He already has 55 yards rushing in this game. Sets up second and short. And he's got it again. This time he slips before he gets to the 30-yard line. And the Turf Monster with its first tackle.
And Ron, it was second and about five after that big run, overcoming that penalty on first down. And it puts Kansas State right now in a third and manageable situation. That's the way they have to make hay in this offense. They have to stay in this third and manageable situation, overcome penalties, and continue to do the little things right.
Well, they're running the football successfully, averaging about 6.5 yards. Here comes pressure. Gregory steps away, lost it. It's going to be incomplete. Intended for Thomas, who was coming out of the backfield. Holden Tharp was the one coming up from the linebacker spot to put the pressure on Gregory. Gregory, though, did a nice job at least sidestepping that.
You can see the subtle little movement in the pocket avoids the pressure that you talked about. The middle linebacker Thorpe was coming right up the middle. A little better pass down the sideline, and he actually could have had Thomas matched up on Stuckey coming up in that run support from that safety position.
Josh Cherry, the junior out of McCook, Nebraska, he's hit his last 5 field goal attempts. This will be a 47-yarder. And he's got the hype, he's got the distance, and he's got the 3. Kansas State 4-1 in 2009 when he scores first. And they have scored first. Josh Cherry's first field goal made from this distance this year. The Wildcats take the lead first.
You know, implementing his system and the way to win right now, and with probably not the exact talent fit to do just that and to be in this position, I think they're right.
Stuckey and McDougal back, and boy, that is just, what the heck was that?
That was Shankopotamus showing up is what that was.
Greasing a very simple pass into the flat to McDougal. He's got the first down over the 50 down to the 48-yard line. Lewis, what do you have for us?
Well, guys, a little update here on Todd Reesing. I've been watching him through the first quarter. Remember, he came off the field after that first interception in the first quarter. Mangino only had a few words to say about it, but Reesing really much sat by himself. He was on the phone, didn't talk much to the other coaches, hasn't gotten any attention that I've seen to the groin. So he's just trying to struggle on through. But watch out for the running back, Jake Sharp. He has a cut over his left eye. As a matter of fact, Grant, their head trainer, was working like a boxing cut man to get that thing closed.
Oh my goodness.
As Mangino's hoping that Reesing can kind of get some things on track here.
Well, Sharp has 3 carries for 6 yards in the ball game. They fake it to him. They get it to Briscoe. And he is going to be thrown to the turf, but not before he gets to the 40-yard line. Let's go back to the first quarter and see if we can see exactly where Jake Sharp may have cut his head.
This is on a 7-yard run early on, and right at the end of the play. Look at that's the bucket that comes off right there. But the play continues. That is very dangerous. That is likely where that cut took place.
Now second down and less than a yard for Kansas. Sharp is in. Meyer goes in motion. Reesing looks to Meyer into the flat. Passes complete first down. A long throw for about 3 yards.
Yeah, Ron, a long throw with pressure in Todd Reesing's face, and he makes a very nice throw. When he has a chance to set his feet and step into his throw, he's okay. It's when he has to adjust and move a little bit where he just does not look like himself.
Now they go 3 wide receivers to the left. Meyer is on the inside, Sharp alone in the backfield. Briscoe wide to the right.
This safety typically is the guy that's going to try to get over top of Briscoe to give him help.
They fake to Sharp. Reesing steps up. This is where he's dangerous. They try to hack at the football, but Reesing gets down to the 30-yard line. Felder on the tackle, and Reesing looks a little ginger there.
He looks a little ginger, but it's going straight forward, which I don't think is a real big issue. But look right there. There's a little bit hitch in his step. And I don't expose my starting quarterback in the run game when he's a little nicked up anyway. I don't really like the play call right there. Figure out a better way to get yards in this football game.
It's hard to go against your tendencies, though, isn't it?
It is. I think that's a great point. But when you're nicked up at the quarterback position, you have to adjust.
Here comes pressure by K-State. Reesing reads it. Pass incomplete. Intended for Ingram. Ingram looked like he was trying to spin before he had the ball in his hand.
And Pumelli was coming out of that middle linebacking position, squeezing down that zone. Briscoe just needed to stay where he was initially, and that ball that Reese threw would have been right on him.
Third down and five. He'll go from the shotgun. Inside the 20, down to the 17-yard line. Now for his career receiving, and he's given the Jayhawks first and 10 from the 17. Wide open far side, Briscoe looks for Pater. Does he get in? Yes, touchdown, Kansas.
Off the play action, Kansas State is coming off the corner to try to get down inside. That defender right out there in front of Briscoe is number four, Josh Moore. Once he commits to the run game, quarterback Reese pulls it out and throws it to Briscoe.
And the extra point is good. Des Briscoe, his sixth touchdown reception of the year.
The play action pass is meant to influence Moore. Get it to your playmaker Briscoe and let him cash it in. Kansas needs something good to happen. This is a very good thing right here by Briscoe. Short passing game, rhythm throwing by Reesing, and he was in a rhythm on that series.
This is going to be a high pooch kick by Brandstetter. They don't want Brandon Banks touching that football. Let's go back to the touchdown again, because it appeared as though Briscoe was not well covered, shall we say.
Well, the stack formation is make the defense think over here, but the play action pass is really meant to influence this guy. As he steps inside, Briscoe's going to get the football, and then it's just a race to the end zone. Right there, the influence of the play action pass. Joshua Moore is affected by it, steps inside. Briscoe, it's just cash and carry from that point in time, and that's exactly what he did.
Well, Reesing was 5 of 6 for 55 yards in that drive, and not a lot of rolling out in that possession. We saw him run once. He looked like he got up very slowly from that. Maybe the last time we see that.
I would agree.
Kansas State, let's see if they can answer it. Ball's on the 28-yard line. Gregory straight drop going down the middle. Has Banks. He outruns the defense, and he drops it. Brandon Banks blew by the double coverage, and he had six on that one.
This is actually the same play, the play action pass. Banks is going on a deep post route with the middle open. Davis is covering him right there, but it's the throw perfectly, finish the play. The easy part is running the route. The hard part is to finish the play. That was a great opportunity that went by the wayside for Kansas State.
Second drop by the Wildcats this afternoon. A little razzle-dazzle. They give it to Banks. He's got a wall in front of him. There's the block. He just barely gets nicked. My goodness. Stuckey got a piece of him and turned him around, but he was gone, Kelly. Picked up 20 on the play.
Well, the double reverse, and you can see eventually Banks right there is going to get the ball. And the wall is set up to that side, and Stuckey does a tremendous job of really basically splitting a double team in that wall that K-State has formed. Ron, we saw from up here, that quite frankly should have been a touchdown. A great play by Stuckey.
You saw Michael Smith, one of the assistant coaches, one of the most prolific receivers in Kansas State history, talking to him afterward. Here's Valentine. We get to see him for the first time, the senior out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Let's go back to that play again. Stuckey made a heck of a play on it.
Well, the double reverse, and then stop it right there. He's double teamed. He's going to split it and just basically get his right hand on Banks. A tremendous play, because that was destined for the end zone if Stuckey doesn't make a tremendous play.
Well, Stuckey hurt his elbow early on in the season. He's had this brace on. He's not only a great football player, he is an outstanding student and individual in the community. And here's Banks. He's got the football. Penalty flag is down as he goes inside the 30-yard line and is stood up at the 28. But we have a flag back at the 47-yard line, and Grant Gregory's walking back.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness on the offense, number 59. Leg whip. 15-yard penalty. Second down.
Now that's Zach Kendall. That's the first time I've heard that called in a couple of years.
Yeah, Zach Kendall, Ron, is the left guard, so it's to the backside of this play. His block doesn't really matter a lick.
Well, Bill Snyder's questioning it, I think. He wants to talk to the referee on this.
Zach Kendall is to the backside of the play. He's right here. Eventually, he's going to leg whip a guy, is what the receiver said. Banks has the ball and is gone.
Well, he's just kind of rolled over, it looked like, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't know about that. That was a little tough. But to the backside of a play, that's a hard one to take, because that block was really not needed at all. You could basically turn your guy loose, and it's not going to influence where Banks goes.
Fourth penalty on Kansas State. Last couple of games, they've averaged 8 penalties a game. Gregory looks, tucks, and Kansas covers it up. Picks up about a half a yard on the play, up to about the 35-yard line. Tell you though, we have to talk about Bill Snyder not afraid to go back to Banks after he misses that wide open touchdown catch.
We talked at the top about Banks being that big chunk of yardage guy for this offense. He missed the touchdown catch, but you have to continue to feed your playmaker. Essentially, he's the only playmaker out wide. Thomas running the football, Banks out wide. Absolutely, you come right back to him and try to let him get it done again.
They fake to Valentine. And now Gregory's got plenty of time. Looking, tucking. And he is going to be run out of bounds abruptly at the 41-yard line. Angus Quigley, the former running back, coming up to make the stop. And that'll bring up fourth down. So just like when it looked like K-State was moving the football, Kelly, boom, stop sign comes up.
Yeah, and don't forget that big play by Darryl Stuckey where he split the double team on that double reverse, prevented a touchdown, and then it was great coverage in the secondary. Kansas State was play-actioning off their run game and trying to go deep, and Kansas did a nice job in the back end.
Ryan Haig, the true freshman. This is a boomer. High spiraling kick. Back at the 5-yard line. Bradley McDougal is dropped. Outstanding kick of Fidrett.
Very good on that last drive in particular. We'll see if he can keep it up on this one.
Only 181 yards passing last week versus Texas Tech. That's the fewest since last year against Kansas State. He's forced to run again. Will he take a knee? No. Loses the football. Kansas State looks like they may have it. And they do. Turnovers in the last 4 games now for Todd Reese.
This actually looked like it was another designed draw. If you can look at Jake Sharp, you can see the strip right at the end. Can't make out who did it. I think it was
Hartman.
Hartman, you were exactly right, with that right arm stripping the football. Another designed draw to the quarterback that's hurting. I don't agree with it. It was straight ahead. You can see Jake Sharp was leading him up inside. So it was a designed play and just not very good ball security at the end of it by Reese.
Well, we had the interception. It's actually 9 turnovers in the last 3.5 games.
The key for Kansas State is to turn it into points. They can't let this opportunity slide by.
They run the option looking for Thomas. Gregory keeps it. He's got the corner. Tiptoes down the sideline, knocked out at the 12-yard line. Pickup of 13 on the play for Grant Gregory.
This is the first time we've seen what they call a speed option. It's quick to the other end of the line of scrimmage. Option off the first guy who runs supports. Gregory does a nice job. If Stuckey goes up to the pitch man, Gregory doesn't even break stride and gets around the left end.
Nice job by Stringer, Kendall, and Weiberg, the left side of that offensive line. Now it's first and 10 from the 11. Six on the line of scrimmage defensively for Kansas. Now they back off. They got to call a timeout. Kansas State threatening against arch rival Kansas in the Sunflower Showdown, the 107th edition, 98th consecutive year they've played this game. First and 10 from the 11. Gregory fakes, keeps the pump. Kansas pursuing, and they'll drop him down at the 12-yard line. He'll lose a couple on the play. Led by Justin Springer, the junior out of Los Fresnos, Texas. And we talked about the turnover the first five games and what it's been the last three games.
Holy cow.
Wow.
And this is what Kansas State is focused on right now. They have this takeaway that they just received, and they need to turn it into a touchdown, because Reesing and company are going to score some points today. Mm-hmm. You have to get while the getting is good for Kansas State.
They're still very patient to let the clock run inside of 4 minutes left in the half.
And Banks is right there. He's the guy that has the quickness and speed to get loose down here in the red zone.
One to snap it, and they get it off. Valentine's the pitch man, and he's got it. Kansas pursuing, and they drag him down to the 15-yard line. He'll lose yardage again. Lubbock Smith, the redshirt freshman out of Dallas, Texas, coming up from that free safety spot. A lot of changes Mark Mangino made, not only on the offensive line, but he also on the defensive side said he took guys off the scout team and then trimmed their defensive package, Kelly.
And I think what that does, the result, Ron, is it makes, or it allows, I think, the defenders to play faster. If you don't have to think about so much, your feet move faster, and that's what he's seen defensively right now.
Third down and 14. Kansas showing blitz, and here they come on Gregory, and he's going down. Justin Thornton leading the charge, his first sack of the year.
Justin Thornton is just one of the guys. He's going to be coming here, but you have the pressure up the middle as well as the offensive line and running back slide inside to protect against the most dangerous. Then Thornton comes free outside. A great time for pressure, and Thornton is that guy. Gets up and knows that his defense just got off the field.
Now Josh Sherry back in. He already has one field goal today, the junior. He has hit his last six field goal attempts. This one's got the distance. And it is no good. Boy, oh boy, you just mentioned against Kansas, you know they're going to hang some points on you. You got to get while the getting's good.
This is not a good example of it, and this was, once again, it's not hooked. Doesn't really have a lot of bend in it, but it's just pushed right from the beginning. Not a very confident stroke right there. Didn't really finish, it didn't look like, but you get the big takeaway. The strip by, we saw it on tape earlier after that play, it was a Fitzgerald, the big defensive end, hustling down, and Kansas State gets nothing out of it.
Well, Kansas has plenty of time, but just over 210 is Bradley McDougal on the reception. And Kansas is going to try to hurry things up as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes. Kerry Meyer now going to the far side. He's going to be joined by McDougal. Recent 12 for 1,820 yards. A little shuttle pass to Sharp. Nothing doing. Opulham tried that earlier in the ball game. The pass hit him in the forehead. This time Sharp gets the hands on it, but a big zero on yardage gain.
Kansas trying to find some way to get their run game going. They've been willing to expose Reesing in the run game on a couple of draws. And that time, the flip to Sharp didn't work very well. So the short passing game really has become Kansas's running game this afternoon.
Only 17 yards rushing in the first half for Kansas. Reesing spun around. He's going to run again. He's got the first down, and he slides and then takes a hit at about the 38-yard line.
And this is where Reesing is at his best. You get pressure off of both edges, but watch where he goes at the end. It's up the middle with this whole drum. can do that straight ahead stuff. It's that spin that caused a little delay.
Now he goes, looks for the pass, and he'll short hop it to Meyer. Coming up at halftime, stay tuned for the Nissan Heisman Watch. Now things are starting to break up in the Heisman.
What's Big Row back in the studio? What's he saying about the Heisman? Hard to tell at this point.
I'm sticking with Colt McCoy.
Tune in for that and see what he has to say, and maybe I can counter that in the second half here.
Well, Kansas has 56 seconds to work with before halftime. Looking right where three wide receivers were. Pumps, throws, too high for Kerry Meyer. And that'll bring up a third down and 10 with 49 seconds left in the half.
The last two pass attempts haven't been Todd Reese's best. We've seen in the drive before, he was in rhythm, 5 out of 6, and got Briscoe into the end zone. On this drive, it hasn't been the same. This ball's not coming out right. He hesitates when he has to escape, and he doesn't look comfortable.
Well, they have no running game, which has really hurt him in this first half. Reese has to put everything up, 5 to snap it. And he is dancing around. Time looked at Sharp. Now he's in trouble. Penalty flags going down. Greasing, this may be for naught. And he takes a lot of, loses the football. And Kansas State will have it. Lemure on the recovery.
Holding on the offense, number 77. Penalties declined. First down.
Second fumble for Todd Reese today to go along with an interception.
Todd Reese, once again, initially has all the time in the world because it's only a 3-man rush. But right there, not being able to escape out the side door, doesn't know there's a holding penalty behind him, tries to pick up the first down. The heavy hit, and Lemure picks it up. And you can see Thomas and Hulk were the ones that on that heavy hit. But the quarterback trying to make something happen, but he doesn't know that there's a holding penalty behind him. It's all for naught anyway.
3 turnovers in this first half for Kansas. Kansas State now with 30 seconds left into a short passing game. That's Lamarck Brown out of Hazelwood, Missouri. And Kansas State, though, trailing 7-3. And this turnover problem for Kansas, this is a bug. This is H1N1 here.
But Kansas State has bailed them out so far, though. They haven't been able to convert.
Right.
They need to get points off of turnovers. Taking it away is one thing, but it means nothing if you don't convert.
That's exactly right. It's like basketball. Gregory's pass, sideline again to Brown. K-State, only one timeout left. Clock stopped with 26 seconds left in the first half.
And there's plenty of time still here in the plus 31 to be able to get this ball, drive a couple more plays to try to get it into the end zone as opposed to just settling for the field goal right now.
Well, Cherry has made one and missed one field goal attempt today. Now,
his Banks is that go-to guy again in that slot. Look for Kansas State to try to get him the football.
And Gregory looking, has a man, Brown, got it inside the 5, touchdown, Kansas State. That was the Lamarck Brown scoring drive, all 3 pass completions for the junior out of Hazelwood, Missouri.
And Ron, I circled Banks before that play, and if you don't throw the ball to your playmaker, you let your playmaker influence the defense and throw it to Brown. Banks ran a post route inside, took 2 defenders. Brown was left open outside.
And the extra point, which has been an exciting play for Kansas State, is good. K-State 4-0 when they lead at halftime this year. Let's take a look at that last play again.
Well, Banks is the inside receiver, and he's actually going to take coverage with him. At the end of the play, Brown is going to go outside on the corner route. Nobody is there because 2 defenders went with the 1 receiver inside, which was Banks. That they have to go up to Austin next week and play a Texas team that's playing probably their best football of the year.
Josh Cherry's kickoff is going to be very, very short. Fielded at the 22-yard line. up to the 40-yard line with about 14 seconds left to play.
And Ron, I don't think it's out of the realm of possibility with that decent return by McDougal with 14 seconds. You have a chance for a couple of plays. You still have two timeouts. Try to get in field goal range and steal some points here at the end of the this first half.
Well, if Kansas goes in the first half like it is now, they'll look and they'll say, well, we're averaging about 3 yards a carry rushing the football. No rush game per se, and they look like they're going to take a knee, and they will. Mark Mangino with 3 first half turnovers for his Jayhawks, not taking any chances, and Bill Snyder's team will go to the locker room with the advantage 10-7. Kansas State trying to go 5-0 at home this year for the first time since 2002.
Okay.
Here's Lewis.
Kansas had 3 turnovers. How important was it to finally score a touchdown off that last one?
Well, I mean, it goes without saying. You know, yeah. if you don't get it in the end zone, you're not going to win any ball games.
All right, and how do you keep Kansas shut out here in this second half?
Well, I don't know if you can. I mean, they're too good of an offensive football team. Todd's a great quarterback. I don't know if we can. You know, we'll try, but there's no guarantee, that's for sure.
All right, Bill, thank you. Ron?
All right, thank you, Lewis. Score at halftime, Kansas State leading the Jayhawks 10-7. Now let's join Al Troutwig, Roland Williams, Christian Fourier in our Versus studio with the Geico Halftime Show.
Okay, Ron.